عندما تصلك رسالة فإنها تستولي على اهتمامك حتى وإن لم تعرف المرسل. وإذا عرفته أصبحت الرسالة تخصك أكثر. وكلما كان المرسل غاليا أكثر كانت الرسالة غالية أكثر. فكيف إذا كان المرسل هو الله عز وجل؟ القرآن رسالة الله إليه.
20,000 Americans every year decide to convert to Islam. These converts say they don't regret their decision at all.
Growing numbers of young Australian men and women who are converting to Islam.
One of the world's largest religions is gaining followers from a very unlikely community. A growing number of Hispanics are changing their religion and following the teachings of Islam.
The number of converted Muslims in Norway increased to at least 3,000.
4,000 personnes en moyenne chaque année, généralement des jeunes et de culture ou de foi chrétienne, choisissent de devenir musulmans.
The latest U.S. census suggests many of them are turning to Islam.
According to a report by Faith Matters, the U.K. is seeing a surge in Brits converting to Islam. In the last year, around 5,200 people in Britain converted to Islam. As many as 100,000 have converted in the last decade.
Here in the United States, while the Muslim contingent numbers an estimated 7 to 8 million, it's growing rapidly. 20,000 new converts each year, four times as many women as men.
Islam is the fastest growing religion in all of Canada.
Laut einer Studie sind seit 2004 jedes Jahr rund 4000 Bundesbürger zum Islam übergetreten. Das sind viermal so viele wie in den Jahren zuvor.
It's the world's fastest growing religion, Islam.
Islam is the fastest growing religion in the world.
Islam remains the fastest growing religion.
Converting to Islam, 100,000 converts now is up from an estimated 60,000 10 years ago. The majority are women with an average age on conversion of 27.
Despite those statistics, Islam is the fastest growing religion in Europe.
But Islam has actually been attracting more and more Americans every day.
That may be no surprise, since a quarter of the estimated 6 million Muslims in the United States are converts.
Growing numbers of white British women are converting to Islam. But why would they want to give up all the freedoms their Western life allows?
I don't know if you're aware, but recently there's been a rise of Latinas converting into Islam. So why are they doing it?
Crossing over, why so many young Australian men and women are now converting to Islam.
So what's going on? What is compelling so many young white women to convert to Islam?
After going to Catholic school for 12 years, my faith needed a little bit more depth in it, and I was able to find it in Islam.
In fact, she says it was Jesus himself who led her to Islam.
You think Jesus led you to become a Muslim?
Yes, yes.
That Muslims believe in Jesus, we love Jesus so much, and we cannot necessarily, we can't even be Muslim really if we don't believe in Jesus, because that's one of our stepping stones to our religion. We do have to believe that the Torah and the Gospel were a book that was sent to prophets from God.
We grew up in the Baptist world that I was raised in, and the ministry. If you go into the Middle East and find a Catholic or a Protestant, they pray to Allah as well. So, and then people look at me going, really? Yeah, the Catholics in their mass will go, whatever, pray, whatever, and Allah.
Yes. So,
I mean, it's not like a Muslim term. I'm seeing the message of God has never changed. I read the Quran and I see that thread of the message of God from Adam to Abraham, Moses, David, Saul, all the way through to Muhammad. You go to the Bible and you find the way we pray in Islam.
Abraham. Abraham fell face down on the ground. Moses. And Moses quickly bowed his head toward the earth and worshipped. Jesus, he fell with his face to the ground and prayed.
What prompted your decision to convert to Islam?
I started just to have big questions about life, the universe and everything. And I started to explore lots of different answers to those questions. And much to my surprise, Islam seemed to be the one that continually came back to me with the answers that made the most sense to me.
When you look at this photo of Angela Collins, she looks like the all-American girl with blonde hair and gorgeous blue eyes. But that was the old Angela. Now you wouldn't recognize her. Today, Angela never shows her blonde hair in public. In fact, she never goes out without being covered up, because Angela is a recent convert to Islam. She is now a Muslim.
What do you want people to know about why you converted?
I was seeking truth, and I found it in my religion.
So, looking at Angela today versus the Angela that you grew up with,
mm-hmm.
do you see her as being happier today?
Yes. Yes, I do.
So you see this as a positive change?
Absolutely.
And Angela isn't alone in converting to Islam. In fact, an estimated 20,000 Americans each year become Muslims and join mosques.
Venons-en au dossier de cette édition consacrée à la décision prise par 30 à 70 000 personnes en France de se convertir à l'islam. Ce sont essentiellement des femmes qui font ce choix. Pour quelles raisons? C'est ce que Pierre-Nicolas et Jean-Michel Mire ont demandé à deux d'entre elles. Écoutons leur témoignage.
Islam is growing faster than ever, with some studies suggesting it's on the way to becoming the dominant faith.
According to that same population projection, Muslims are the only major religious group expected to grow faster than the global population as a whole. And here's another point worth mentioning.
The growth rate of population of the different religious communities in the same period was for Hindus 16.8%, Muslims 24.6%, Christians 15.5%, Sikhs 8.4%, Buddhists 6.1% and Jains 5.4%.
Kai Lühr ist nicht alleine. Wie das Islamarchiv unter Leitung von Salim Abdullah herausfand, sind im vergangenen Jahr etwa 4000 Menschen in Deutschland zum Islam übergetreten. Deutlich mehr als sonst.
And why shouldn't they be? Islam is the fastest growing religion in the UK. New analysis of census figures even suggests that it could become the country's dominant religion in as little as 10 years' time. The number of Muslims in the UK has doubled in the past decade, with Muhammad now the most popular name for baby boys in London.
There will come a time, as Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, that Islam will enter into every home, even a home of hair, even a home of mud, even meaning a tent. There will be a person in that home who is Muslim. In the Sunan of Imam Ahmed, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, this matter will keep spreading as far as the night and the day reach.
The headlines say Islam is going to be the largest religion in the world.
But Islam will grow faster than any other major religion.
Islam is the world's fastest growing religion.
Islam is the only religion growing faster than the world's population.
20 years ago, there were 1.1 billion Muslims in the world, but according to a new study, 20 years from now, that number could double. By 2030, Muslims will represent more than a quarter of all people on the planet. And here in the United States, the number of Muslims will more than double.
How big Islam has become in Russia's capital city. Tens of thousands come to mark Ramadan, so many that some must even pray outside.
A new report by the Pew Forum shows Islam is the fastest growing religion.
Over 20 million Muslims are celebrating the festival at over 24,000 mosques. In the capital city of Urmqi, over 10,000 gathered in one mosque for morning prayer.
This is one of the 20,000 mosques in Xinjiang. Devoted Muslims come here every day and pray for five times, facing the direction of Mecca. During Ramadan, they extend the last prayer from 10 minutes to 2 hours. Along with the fasting, it's intended to get closer to God.
Well, our next guest did just that. After being a Catholic priest in Britain, he left to become a teacher and studied in Egypt, where he converted to Islam and became a Muslim. He is now in Ireland to spread the word of the Quran, and he joins us in studio this morning. Good morning to you.
Hello, this is Dr. Gerald Dirks, formerly the Reverend Gerald Dirks. In just a few moments here on The Dean Show, we'll be talking about my conversion to Islam. Please, don't go away.
Many of the miracles that Jesus had done, I found them in the Qur'an. There were even a couple of Jesus' miracles mentioned in the Qur'an that were not mentioned in the Bible.
I had the idea I should look, and that was the first time that I read the Qur'an while I was at Bible college. SubhanAllah, the first time I read the Qur'an, I opened it, just opened it. It fell into Surah, the third chapter, Surah Al-Imran.
Mm-hmm.
And I was reading about Jesus. I said, oh my God, I didn't know Jesus was in this book. Mary, Zachariah, the prophets, all the prophets. And I'm reading their history, you know, the story of their lineage, their ancestry there, and how God has connected the story. Amazing, amazing story. And I was shocked. See, I did something I would never do today, but I threw the Quran away. I threw it on the table. I threw it because it scared me. Because suddenly I realized from that one short reading, I had another option. And I kept reading. And I kept reading until I got to this verse in the Qur'an, in Surah Al-Ma'idah 83. In this passage, God is talking to the Christians. Maybe you know this verse. Those who are the Christians, or who call themselves the Christians, when they hear this word of God, this message that is sent to the Rasul, to Muhammad, when they see that, you see their eyes fill with tears. A sheikh, my eyes had tears in them when I read that verse. SubhanAllah. And it says, they will say, mark me as a believer, mark me as a shahada, a witness to this truth. And I knew I was a Muslim at that day. I knew I was a Muslim because I knew that the Quran was the word of God, because nothing could change me if it wasn't actually God changing me.
Have to be something beyond what we understand as ordinary human experience to account for the writings that we've seen.
In a relatively few ayah is contained a rather comprehensive description of human development from the time of commingling of the gametes through organogenesis.
Intensive studies of the Quran and Hadith in the last 4 years have revealed a system for classifying human embryos that is amazing, since it was recorded in the 7th century AD.
Somebody who did not know something about nuclear physics 1400 years ago could not, I think, be in a position to find out from his own mind, for instance, that the earth and the heavens had the same origin, or many other of the questions that we have discussed here.
We need research into the history of early Middle Eastern oral traditions to know whether, in fact, such historical events have been reported. If there is no such record, it strengthens the belief that God transmitted through Muhammad bits of his knowledge that we have only discovered for ourselves in recent times.
Summary. The Quran describes not only the development of external form, but emphasizes also the internal stages, the stages inside the embryo of its creation and development, emphasizing major events recognized by contemporary science.
By reading Quran and by answering to your questions, I think I can find my future way for investigation of the universe.
This is definitely not a simple human knowledge. A normal human being cannot explain this phenomenon in that much detail. So I thought some supernatural or extra human being the data or the information might have come from some supernatural source.
We're talking about 1,200 years ago. You have someone, a literate person, making profound pronouncements and statements that are amazingly accurate of a scientific nature. And I personally can't see how this could be a mere chance. There are too many accuracies.